In this lesson, we will add two charts to the dashboard for a quick analysis over the issues of the application. In one chart, we want to represent the proportion of issues by priority, and on the other chart, we want to show the number of issues submitted over the last 7 days. So let me first just add here some structure to the page to hold these charts. I will add a container below these lists and another container inside this one that I will size to 6 columns. So this will be one of the containers for the charts. I will add another container next to this one for the second chart. Now, let me add another container for the title of the first chart. And this will be the workload. And set the style of this container to be heading 1. And let's remove here this margin that we don't need. Let me add a container below this one. There. And now I want to add a chart here on this container. And the charts, pretty much like the widgets in the previous videos, they are available by default when you create a new eSpace module. You'll find them under this charts option here. And the chart that I want to use for the proportion of issues is a pie chart. So let me just add it here to the container. And this pie chart widget works pretty much like the table records or the list records. We need to feed it with a list of records that will represent the data points of the chart. And these records, they have a structure. And this structure is, you'll find it under here, under the charts option, this is the data point structure. So this structure represents a value in the chart. So for this first chart, the workload pie chart, we need to create a variable here, which will be the workload. And this will be a record list of data points. So this variable will have the list of values to show on the chart. So we need to bind it to the chart. And I am also going to set the height of the chart to be 200. Now, we need to initialize this list with the values that we want to represent on this chart. And we'll do that on the preparation of the screen. And the values that we want to show on the chart are the number of high priority issues, the number of low priority issues, and the number of issues that are unclassified. Now, we already have here a couple of queries that get me the high priority issues and the low priority issues. We can use the count property of these queries to get those values. We need to have the number of unclassified issues as well. And we're going to reuse the action that we created on a previous video. So let's go here into the logic. This action here, count issues by priority. And using this action with the priority ID set to null, we are going to count the number of unclassified issues. So we have everything that we need. Now we need to initialize our list, our record list of data points. And to do that, I'm going to use another action that comes from this charts component. This is the data point init action. Basically, this action initializes a record of that structure data point. So we need to pass these values here, the label and the value. These are the mandatory ones. And we're going to pass also the color for this pie chart. So let's go ahead and do this. The label, so the first value will be for the high priority. And the value for the high priority, we'll get it from the count property of this query. There. Now, we need to set also the color, and I'm going to use the same colors we used for the CSS for the dashboard page. In this case, this is going to be E70101, and that's it. So we have a record for our chart. What we need to do now is to add this record to our workload record list. And to do that, I'm going to use another action here. This is a built-in action called list append, this first one. Basically, this action appends to this first parameter, to the record list. So let's select here workload. It appends to this record list, the record that we just initialized with this action, this one. And that's it for the high priority. We need to repeat these steps for the other two values. So let me just get some space here. And I'm going to copy paste these two notes and reconnect here the list append to this other node. Now, for this data point initialization, we're going to set the low priority value. And again, the value comes from the count property and now from this other query. There. And we're also going to set the color. So let me just delete this. And the color for the low priority is, so let me just put here the hash sign, F28900. And we need to append now this data point to our workload. And actually, this is already fixed for me. When I copy paste, this was already fixed. So it is appending the data point from this initialization. So it's done. Let's finish this chart with the third value. So again, copy paste these two nodes and connect these ones. And on this data point in E3, we're going to set the value for the unclassified. So this will be for the unclassified issues. And we'll get that value from the action in this case, not the query, the action that we used to count the unclassified issues. So this value here. And we'll also set the color for this one. And the color will be all A values. So 6 A's here. And we're done. So let's just connect this. And our chart is done. Let's just do the second chart before we publish so that we can see everything in place. So again, coming back here to the dashboard, our part chart is done. Let's have a title for our second chart. So again, add a container here. This will be a heading one for the title. And this will be the submitted issues. And let me just remove here this margin. So add another container below this one. And the chart that we're going to use, in this case, this will be a line chart. And again, pretty much like the pie chart, we need to have a record list of data points. So I'm going to show you another way for you to initialize a record list of data points. And the way that you're going to do this, since this data point is a structure, we can use this structure as an output of an advanced query. So let's go ahead here to the preparation and let's add an advanced query here. And this will be the get submitted issues. And let me just arrange here the flow, double click, set the output structure of this advanced query to be data point. And now I'm going to copy paste the SQL from the clipboard. Not going into too much detail about this SQL here, but it basically gets me the number of issues in each day from the last 7 days. And now I need to bind the output of this query. I'll need to bind this output to my widget on the screen. So here, this will be the output of this query. And again, I'm going to set the height of this chart to be 200 as well. And we're all done. So let's publish and see our application. And here we have our application, our dashboard, now with a couple of charts showing the workload and the number of submitted issues over the last 7 days. And that's it.